Okay. To illustrate the operation of the LSQ, we will do an example. So here I have a loadster queue, where this is the oldest instruction and this is the youngest instruction in the queue. Note that the queue is storing instructions in the correct program order. So basically, in program order, this was the first load, this was the second instruction, and so on. This says whether it's a load or a store. This tells us what address the load or store was fetched from. This is the sequence number, basically just going up. And this is the address to which the load or the store resolves to. And this is the value that we will get for that load or store. And let's say that this is the content of the data cache. Let's say that the initial content of the data cache is 42 here, 1 here, 38 here, and 1, 2, 3, 4 here. This load goes first, accesses address 3290, which is this one, and loads the value of 42. Let's say now that this store here computes its result. It basically gets the value it's gonna store. Let's say that it gets 25. Note that this store doesn't really put that value yet in the cache. That will happen when it commits. So this is only that we have gotten the value from the instruction that produces the register that we will use as our source value to store in memory. Let's say that this next store also gets a value of -16 this time. Now let's say that this load executes next, accesses the address 3418, and it tries to see whether any of the previous stores matches that address. They don't, so it loads the value from memory. This is the address in the cache that matches this, so we're gonna get 1234. Next, this load tries to load the value. It has the address of 3290. It's going to search upward for the latest store that still precedes it that matches the address, and it finds one. This store is having the address of 3290. So instead of going to the cache, we are directly gonna copy just the value of -17 here. So now we actually had a load that never really accesses the cache. It just gets the value from the store. The next load accesses address 3300. It searches the previous stores and doesn't find any that match this address. So it's gonna go to the cache and load from address 3300, and it gets 1. Next, we have another store to 3290. Let's say that the value stored there is now 0. Next, we have a load from 3410. It searches the previous accesses for a store that matches this address, and it finds one over here, so it just copies the value of 25. So again, we have a load that never accesses the cache because it found what it needed in the load store queue. Next, we have a load to 3290. It searches the load store queue to find a store that matches this address, and it finds one over here. So it just copies the value of 0 here. Note that by now, there have been several stores to 3290. We always want to get the value from the most recent one that still precedes us, because if things were happening in order, one at a time, this is exactly what the value should be in the memory location. Note, however, that the memory location, as far as the cache and the memory are concerned, still contains the value of 42 at this time, although there have been several modifications. Why? Well, because the stores haven't sent the values to the data cache yet. And finally, we have another load to 3300. It searches backward to find any stores to the same address. Note that this is a load, we don't do that. So there are no stores to the same address, so we actually load the value from the cache, and the value is 1. Now let's say that at some point the loads and stores start committing. So we will have this load commit. A load commits by simply copying the value to the register file, and now the oldest pointer is here. The store commits by putting the value in the cache. So now we take the value of 25 and put it in address 3410. So we override this 38 with 25, and now the store can commit, and our pointer moves here. We commit another store here, so the value of -17 goes to location 3290. So we override this 42 with 17. Now our store is committed. We move the pointer here. If you remember, we said that we need to send the values to the memory or the data cache at the time the store commits, not at the time it executes. Here's why. If at this point we decide that we are taking an exception, we can just flush this from the load store queue, and the value in the data cache and memory is exactly the value that should be there as of this point in the program execution. So just like we had our architectural register file and we were copying values on commit into it for registers so that at any given time we know exactly what the committed registers value are, similarly, at any given time, we have in our data cache and memory exactly what is there as of the commit point. This process will now go on. The load commits and deposits this value in its register. Another load can commit, and another one. When the store commits, it overrides this 17 with a 0, and then the loads commit, and the final content of the cache is this.